Here we are, four groups of boys, and our expert says a powerful truth.
They can learn the knowledge. They could sit down, we could ask them to repeat it, but you can't educate curiosity out of a child.
So you may be wondering, were there any kids who did follow the rules, and who were they?
Oh, I found the gun!
Only one girl out of 14 even touched a gun, and most of them ran out for help. And there were also older boys who seemed to have more resistance. There, in the red shirt, is 10-year-old Kendrick, who acts like a crossing guard for the younger boys.
It's a real gun!
He even tries to come up with a diversion.
Just take some animal crackers.
And in another group, another older boy, 10-year-old Ari.
There could be real bullets in there. I don't know.
Maybe we will shoot the window.
We are not shooting anything, okay?
Or the window.
Yes, even the window. Because if we accidentally hit that, it could cost the turtle's life. So whatever you do, do not touch the guns.
Professor Sanfilippo asks Ari to step out of the room to congratulate him on being careful around guns.
You should be really proud of yourself.
I am. When I saw the gun, I wanted to spring into action. And I felt really good about that.
No!
But with Ari now out of the room, the younger boys are all alone. Do five-year-olds really grasp guns and danger? When one of the boys touches the gun, the other seems afraid and dives for cover.
I'm going to stay under the table, okay? I'm going to stay under the table.
Nope. No bullets?
No bullets?
Nope.
The frightened boy comes out and pulls the trigger, just to be sure.
Yeah, no bullets.
No fear left. One child pulls the trigger on his friend, and then himself. They know how to play dead, but as we saw over and over, do they really know what death is?
We'll die.
It's not until much later in childhood and adolescence that children understand that death doesn't mean going to sleep.
After our experiment, David Muir sat down with some of the parents to watch the videotapes. A mom who said she'd been sheltering her son even from seeing violent movies or guns on TV.
Oh my God. I don't even like them watching like the Spider-Man cartoons because it has violence and stuff in it.
Andrea Bevan watching her 6-year-old, and by the way, his dad is in law enforcement.
He was drawn to it, picked it up, pointed it at himself, you know. Click the trigger a few times. Yeah, that's the toughest part. So these guys, you know, guns are about the same seriousness as crickets, frogs, and cookies.
Another mom who thought her 4-year-old hadn't even seen violent media.
That's scary. I have never showed him a gun, and I didn't think he knew what they looked like.
What were you pulling out?
A gun.
And what do guns do to you when you pick them up and touch them?
It can kill you.
It can kill you. We walk away from them, and we don't be around people that have guns, okay?
Yes, Mommy.
Okay.
Yes, Mommy.
Adrian, stop!
Wow.
And this mom who says she not only taught her son Jamie about guns, but told him stories from her job. She works in a hospital operating room where doctors try to save children from death by bullet.
He knows what I do, where I work.
Jamie doesn't want to face his mom.
Oh, God. I'm not looking. I ain't looking.
Yeah.
Do you remember what your mom had told you about guns before?
Sometimes they can be loaded or not, and then, like, you're not supposed to, like, touch them or anything.
What do you wish, Jamie?
I wish you would just delete that.
But what else?
I wish I hadn't touched the gun.
You wish you hadn't touched the gun.
I wish my mom hadn't seen it.
Overall, these were the results of our experiment. More than half of the boys touched the guns, even when promising not to. And the kids reinforced by Eddie Eagle and the local police? Fewer of them touched, but a lot of them did too.
Why was the gun even in here?
That's a very good question.
Very good question.
Okay. You know why the gun was in here? Because we wanted to see what kids would do if they found a gun.
Showing us what so many parents say they wish they had seen.
It just never would have crossed my mind to ask them if they had guns.
Experienced hunters?
And you know, you can't go around saying, well, that can never be me. I never thought I'd be that person either.
And even the deputy sheriff, policeman of the year, and his wife, who want to help everyone save another child. By telling the story of a little boy and a gun way out of reach.
Next, is hiding guns the solution?